our day one started a bit rocky. We hoped our day two would be a smooth sailing. We woke up, we worked, we ate, we took a nap, but we woke up with a terrible headache. We were suffocating in our room.
Yeah, the room smelled like gasoline or
paint thinner.
Yeah, paint thinner, whatever it was. I woke up with a headache and immediately I went down to the front desk and I told them about it. This was around 4:30 in the afternoon. They kind of gave us a runaround and wanted us to explain what happened. I didn't really feel like explaining anything. I just wanted to get to someone of a higher level, a supervisor that can pull a trigger and actually do something about the situation, as opposed to talking to someone at the front desk and then being referred to someone else, and I just keep repeating myself over and over. So I was already agitated with a headache, so they just told us,
go back to your room and wait.
Yeah, well, first of all,
the receptionist suggested to go back to our room and wait.
Yeah, and they wanted to make sure that the room did smell like paint thinner or whatever it was. So Irina waited at the front desk. I went to the room because our room had the do not disturb sign, and they're not allowed to go in under no circumstances if there's a do not disturb sign on. So I went downstairs. There was someone there waiting at the door. And I walked them in. The moment I opened the door, you can instantly smell. And she kind of just kind of walked in and she was like, yeah, it smells like paint thinner. Those were her words. So I went back down to the front desk. They radioed in, they confirmed the scent. She put it in the computer, made her notes, and she said, the supervisor will get back to us. She doesn't know because there's no extra rooms available. They won't be able to put us in another room, yada, yada, yada.
And they told us they would contact us via a letter posted to our door.
Right. I didn't want to go back in the room because, like I said, it just really smelled, and I don't know what it was, and I didn't want to be in there. Fast forward later on in the day, 5 hours later, I did go back into the room. The scent dissipated. There wasn't any scent at all. But I took a quick nap, and then when I woke up, like, no letters, no nothing. Irina went downstairs, she checked.
Have not been addressed.
It has not
at
been
all.
Addressed, like, nothing. We didn't even put in a complaint. So that really got under my skin, and I really got irked about the situation. So I went back downstairs to the front desk at 11 p.m. and I said, what's going on? We haven't received any information from the supervisor as opposed to what we're going to do with the situation with the room. Is this the way Norwegian treat their guests? I don't understand, because when we initially told them at 4:30 p.m., they said the supervisor was busy and was taking care of other situations. 5 hours later, nothing. So I'm like, so what, he's still taking care of other things, or she? And this, I figured, needed to be addressed because it had to do with our room and where we would sleep, considering it was already 11 p.m. and people are kind of winding down, want to get into their rooms. So when I approached the front desk person and I told him, listen, at this point I am really pissed off. I don't understand what's going on. I explained the situation over again to her. She looked up the room, looked up the notes, and apparently she wanted to send someone in the room to check again to see if it had a smell. I told him Irina was in the room. I don't know if she's sleeping. So I'm like, if it's in the note already, it doesn't make a difference if the room doesn't smell at the moment or if it does, because the point is we want to get out of that room because chances are it could probably happen again. And during sleep, you never know, and I don't know what the scent is. So, took about another half an hour, 40 minutes. And
you don't want to wake up dead, okay?
Yeah, exactly. Wake up dead, well, you're not waking up at all. So,
exactly.
You know, they gave us another room, so now we're in another room. It's the same room. It's not an upgrade. They didn't even offer an apology or anything. They just kind of said, okay, we'll kind of give you guys this room. They're putting the beds together because there were two separate beds in the room. And just give us a moment while we get the room prepared. No apologies, no nothing. That was that's the way our day two went.
Yeah, and now we're at day three. We were supposed to disembark at 8 a.m. But again, Norwegian is
behind
not ready.
A bit. Yeah,
they're not ready.
Behind the clock. But anyway, on a good note,
we're going to Koala Sanctuary today.
Yes, so we're going to go play with koalas and kangaroos and wallabies and everything else. So
the dingo dogs.
Dingo dogs.
So stay tuned.
We're just waiting to get clearance for to be disembarked. We actually docked in this very industrial area, which is about 45 minutes away from
the downtown Brisbane.
Right.
And there is no public transportation that comes to this port. In order to get to the nearest public transportation, you have to take a cab. Or they the cruise ship provides a shuttle bus, which you have to pay for $15 per person, US dollars, for a round trip per day, and we're staying here for 2 days. So it's already $60 extra because they decided to dock far away from the city, and it comes out of our expense.
But on a good note,
it's day three. Just be out with us.
Coming up in our next vlog, we will be visiting the biggest koala sanctuary in Australia, where they have so many koalas, different species of birds, bats, and even a kangaroo that you could take a selfie with. So make sure you hit that subscribe button and turn on that bell notification so you'll be the first to know when the next video comes out. Until then, just be out with us.